Hey guys, it's Kevin. Sometimes you get the clog, sometimes you put the wrong ink into the ET15000, or sometimes you want to change the ink. Either way, you need to prime your damper or draw ink into your damper. So today, Abby is going to show you how to do that. Again, the video is shot in the lab. There were some noises.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. I'm going to be explaining how to draw ink into the dampers on this ET15000 printer. So the first thing we need to do is be able to access the dampers inside the carriage. So I've turned off the printer and I've moved the carriage over to the middle, and then we'll go ahead and open up this scanner by twisting the blue scanner support and lifting the scanner up. Then we need to take out the screws to this upper white plastic piece that kind of covers up the carriage and makes it hard to access, taking off the spring to taking off the damper cover. I believe there should be like 7 screws on this upper front plastic white piece that covers with on the top of the LCD panel. Once we take off all those screws, we'll be able to access where the carriage is. Okay, and so once we get all of our 7 screws out, we'll be able to pick out that white piece. We need to make sure that our scanner support is up and out of the way, because there is a hole on the left side of that white piece where that scanner support goes in. So if it's not detached, we won't be able to lift that up and out. So now we have more room to actually work with the ink tubes and the damper cover and the dampers. There's a spring that is on the left side, or the right side, I'm sorry. If you can't get it off easily with your hand, like I did, you can move that blue lever on the other side towards you, and that should help release the spring easier. I am removing the blue scanner support so I can fit my drill under there and take out the tiny screw holding down the damper cover. Then you can pull up on the tab where on the same side as where that screw was, and then try to pull the damper cover to the right. There is a little prong that goes into a hole on the left side, which is why I'm trying to pull to the right and pull it out. And now we're showing where our dampers are. There's going to be 2 regular screws on either side of those colored ink tubes. So I'm going to take out those 2 screws so we can lift up a bit on our dampers. The next thing I needed to do was open up this plastic tube guard, and then I was able to lift up a bit on these dampers. I don't need to detach the dampers from the tubes because we want to draw ink from the ink tank through the tubes to the dampers, because you can see here there's not much ink in that yellow damper, so it won't have any yellow ink to print with. So you can open up where the ink tanks are, and that's where we'll get a syringe and we'll take it and put it to the bottom of the yellow damper and pull slowly through the syringe to draw yellow sublimation ink through to the yellow damper. And that's basically what I'm going to do with all of the dampers that don't have any ink in them. And then I'll just nicely put back that yellow damper and continue on with the next dampers. So you go ahead and do the same thing. If you feel any resistance, you might see a mistake in the same way that I did at first, where I opened that yellow tank, blue tank cover there, but I forgot to do that with my middle 2, and so I felt some resistance. But that's why when I got to the black, I realized that, okay, I need to open up those blue ink tank covers, and that will help make it a lot easier for the ink to draw through. So once we got all the ink back into our dampers, we can put our dampers back into place, make sure they click into the damper holder, and that's when we're going to go ahead and basically follow our steps backwards. We'll put our two regular screws back in on either side of the colored tubes to help hold them down into place. Closing and opening of the scanner and twisting in and out of that scanner support. But I've said in other videos, if I can keep the scanner attached, I will, just because it's easier for me not to risk breaking any of the hinges or having to reattach any FFC cables. Now we're back on to putting the damper cover in place. The small little tabs go into the back, and that prong is going to slide over to the left side, and there's going to be a tab on the right side of that damper cover that will then snap down into place once you have it lined up with everything where it's supposed to go. All right, and twist open up again so we can put the small screw back into the damper cover. Once we have that in there, then I'm going to go ahead and push that blue lever towards me and work with the spring. The first time I think I might have had trouble, but then I worked on getting it on there. Yeah, it flipped it backwards, so just flip it back again. If you need to use two hands, you can, but it's, for me, I've found that using that spring in this printer, it's always easier to work with my hands than any other tool, but that's personally just me. If it works easier for you to use it with a tool, go ahead. And this is what I meant by two hands, was before I was holding that scanner open, but here you see that I put it back into the blue support system, and now I'm using two hands to help hold the carriage in place and put that back on, that spring back on. So then we're just going to put our plastic tube guide back into place. You just pull it as far as you can, and you'll see there's some three notches that are throughout those tubes in the front, and you hook it on there by pulling back to towards the left side. All right, and that's where you see there's that hole that I was talking about in that upper cover unit towards that front. You have to lift up that support system to put it back in place through that hole. And that's just where we're going to put all of our screws back into place. Really, that was how we did the dampers, pulling ink through. I hope you really enjoyed this video. You can visit us at bchtechnologies.com, or you can visit us locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. All right, happy printing, everyone. That's how we draw ink through the dampers to get better printing if your ink colors aren't coming through. Happy printing.